Good morning, bitch, and welcome to the Morning Tea with Lonnie Bee. Yes, and I am your host, Lonnie Bee, and alongside me is the Tea Party. Oh, everybody is here today. We have the Ridiculous Ron.
What up, though?
Yes, B from the Block. And Semi-Automatic.
Hey, boo.
Yes, we are here today on the Morning Tea with Lonnie Bee. So listen. Uh-huh. How everybody been doing? Okay, first of all, everybody's in joke mode because they've been laughing at me. Let me show y'all something. Everybody but Semi-Automatic, okay?
Thank you.
So I wore this today for our special
it's
guest.
Nice.
Yes, we have a special guest today. She's the preacher's daughter. All right, so I was trying to give a little Catholic effect, okay?
You did.
A little Holy Cross, you know? So it's kind of like see-through, okay?
No, it is see-through. It ain't Honda.
Yeah, okay, it is see-through, yes. Yeah, so you can see these sins, but she's going to pray for me today. All right? Yes. Okay. All right. Yes. And Ron had something to say with his fucking Bill Cosby sweater. Fuck. Shit. Hey. Fuck. Yes. And look at D over there again. He had something to say with a rest in peace shirt on. Fuck.
What you think you were out of here?
Yes. But anyway, so Simi, how have your days been going?
My God. Blessings have been raining down on me. Crazy. In such small ways.
Praise the Lord.
Every little corner.
You look like Elizabeth Taylor done blessed you with that jewelry. Good morning.
How you doing?
tell us about your blessings. What's been going on?
Well, basically, okay, so my sister's boyfriend bought her a new car for Christmas. So she just basically called me. Well, she didn't call me. He actually called me. He was calling from her number.
Oh, okay.
So when I picked up my phone, I saw Sweetie. I was giving, hey, boo. He was like, just say no motherfucker, boo. What's up? What you doing? I said, ooh, well, why you ain't calling my phone from your phone? Because we do have it cool like that.
Right, uh-huh.
And so he was just basically just saying, first he's like, you got $500? Ooh. And I was like, I don't have it. I don't.
We B.O.B.
B.O.B.
Yes.
But when he brought up, it was like, basically, the car they was only going to give her $250 for the car. As
right.
As a trade-in value. And it's right. A really good car.
Right.
So she just gave it to me.
Yeah, look at the Lord.
Look at the Lord.
Look at the look Lord. At the Lord.
And let me tell you something else, Judy B. And I really mean it. And I said it one day.
Right.
When we was riding here.
Yeah.
Because what y'all don't know is.
Uh-huh.
Judy B stays closer to the station, okay?
Uh-huh.
Okay? So, what Judy B do is come get me. So, Judy B has to come all the way back around the way to get me to come back here.
Tell him your testimony.
And have been doing it for me all of this time, and
yes.
I really appreciate it.
Oh,
and
thank
now,
you, Sammy. Thank you. So, don't knock shit on my ID. It's raining.
One thing I'm not is a live fucking melody. I'm moving the fuck on. And just now, you know, look at God and, you know, whatever.
Yeah, you
like
got
that.
Your own wheels and stuff.
It's crazy. So, yeah. Well, I got to get my grind on because she gave me my March to get my coins together to get my insurance right.
Right.
And she's letting me hold on to the her text or whatever like that. I was scrolling down Instagram. You know my birthday is coming up. It's Monday the 16th.
Okay.
And I follow Michelle Blackwell.
Okay.
From the web. And it's one of my favorite web ends, whatever like that. I seen a flyer for the 15th. And I was like, okay, 15th, bring it in at 12 o'clock. At least, you know, the 16th, my birthday.
Right.
So I said, I got to come through there, you know. I commented that. Why did she come back in my DMs? Was like, you know what? I'm going to do a fly for you. So I was like, oh, okay. But, you know, I didn't really take it that seriously. Oh, bitch, while I was in the motherfucking State Farm Insurance office, bitch, she dropped it on Instagram and shouted me out and everything. Bitch, I went off in it.
Yeah!
Like, oh,
look at God.
The Lord.
God is so good. And today we got the preacher's daughter here.
Yes, and I'm glad. I didn't even know. See, that's how you know that was the Lord. It was the Lord, too. Let me come and pick with these puffs on this blazer, and it's a half one.
Yeah.
They don't fuck with me.
Yes! Congratulations to you, Sid.
Thank
yes,
you.
I am so excited. So let's get into this tea here at the Tea Party.
Yes.
Now, y'all know the last time we met, I was telling y'all about Verica Fox and how she was under fire with the gay community.
What?
When she made that statement. You know what I'm saying? About her strippers. She didn't want the gay people coming to see her strippers. So now she came out and she apologized.
And she should.
She apologized.
Of course she would.
No, we're waiting on Kimber Rail. Shit. She apologized. You know
what
I'm saying?
Verica is smart.
Verica is smart. You know, she's protecting that coin.
Yeah.
So she apologized. She also made a statement. She said she's been a friend and supporter of the LGBT community for years. My intentions was not to offend anybody. She said, I am woman enough to apologize if you felt that I have said anything wrong. She said that to Fox 5, Channel 52. Yes. Well, good for you, Verica. Good for you.
Good for you.
So y'all smart. Remember when I told y'all that 17 people got arrested for robbing Kim Kardashian? Mm, yeah. This bitch, that's a neighborhood. That's a neighborhood. 17 people. Mm-hmm. And one of the people that was arrested was her own chauffeur.
Mm. I knew it had some be somebody from
you
the
You said camp. It was inside, y'all.
Yeah. Because nobody knows. Chauffeurs. Right. But guess what? They let him go and kept Ooh. His brother.
Wow.
Ooh, bitch, that's the motherfucker left then.
Yes, bitch. They let him go, but kept his brother. Now, my thing is, why would they let him go if his brother was involved? He had to be involved, too.
Because he snitched on him. His brother probably came up with the idea.
Uh-huh.
And you know what I'm saying? Well, since you on the inside, you were driving, you could do this.
Right.
So he probably told the whole damn story.
Man, mm-hmm. Fucking right.
And get this. According to CNN, the people that robbed her was from the ages of 23 to 73.
Damn.
Bitch. And that 73-year-old was a motherfucker that been pulling professional heights for years to come.
Yes.
Put the whole operation together. You know what's going on?
Yes. Uh-huh. I think the 73 was the old man from Ocean 11.
Bitch. Why not the vision? I said, boom. The 70. Uh-huh. I see.
So anyway, the investigation is still going on. So they're trying to get that going. Okay. Empire been signed on for another season. Are y'all excited?
Nah, I am.
You don't like Empire?
Empire, cool. It got kind of watered down, man.
It's good. It never got watered down.
Or my love for Power just made me stop watching.
Well, Power, I never understood why people keep trying to compare Empire and Power to each other.
Yeah, they're two different shows.
They're totally two different shows. For
one is realer and one is commercial.
Yeah. One is realer and get into a different way, but the right. other one is really a fucking musical in disguise.
Right,
Empire
it
is a musical.
Yeah.
It is.
Well, and just in case you didn't know, Empire is still the number one broadcast drama.
It's on Fox.
Okay, that's on Fox. So, yes, it is. It is. But the views have dropped a lot.
Yeah. Yeah.
The views have dropped. I think it's because the storyline has been getting a little cliche.
I think the whole thing
I'm
is cliche.
I'm just tired of the whole joke. You know, it's like you said, watered down to me. Like it's getting
it is kind of watered down. You like it, though, Simi. That's your show.
But see, I'm
who you like, Jamal?
I love Jamal. I'm in love with Andre.
Oh, okay.
I want the
crazy
one.
Yes. Oh, okay. Okay. Speaking of Kim Kardashian, she's back in the news. Okay, the day that they have reported that they caught the 17 people was the same day somebody robbed her store.
Damn.
Dash. Then I don't know if this bitch walking around here with t-shirts on to say, come rob me. I don't know what's going on.
That is
but they robbed her store. And guess where her store was at? In L.A.
Mm.
On Melrose Place.
Oh, that Melrose? Ooh, that's
yeah.
a real fancy.
How the hell you get away from that?
Melrose Avenue. I'm sorry. Yes, they robbed her store.
There don't be a lot of police out there, though.
They robbed her store the same day, y'all. The same day.
Her, oh, damn.
Yes. In West Hollywood, sorry. Yeah, so they had the cameras
That's
and
a
stuff
hell of a
rolling.
Coincidence.
They had the cameras and stuff rolling, but they didn't catch nobody.
Wow.
They just robbing this bitch.
And they good.
I'm sorry.
Do you think it's because she's too flashy?
Nah, she's
I think
just
it's
easy,
bad karma.
She an easy hit. That's what it is.
You shouldn't be that easy if you that, you know what I'm saying, into the industry like that. You should have President Obama's security.
But it's like
she
sometimes
should,
you don't really be paying attention, you know, because you think, you know what I'm saying, shit, yeah, you get too comfortable. You don't really
Right. I don't know why they doing that to Kim. I'm starting to feel bad for her. I feel so bad for her. Ron don't give a fuck.
I don't.
You don't see that? Like, that's crazy. You don't. Yes. Well, tell me, do you care about this? Fatty Wap got a sex tape out.
Oh, no.
Oh, I care.
So apparently, Fatty Wap got a sex tape out with his ex, Alexis Sky. Now, guess what's going on? Fatty Wap is accusing her of dropping it, and she's accusing Fatty Wap of dropping it. Mm. So they sending their lawyers at each other because nobody know who dropped it. But apparently people in social media world have seen it and they've been putting emojis underneath his pictures of shrimp. Raw, you know what they call it here?
Shrimp.
Aitsy Batesy.
Oh, that's crazy.
That's fucked up.
Oh my
shrimp
God.
Shrimp daddy. Shrimp daddy. That's
it
crazy.
It seems like they going that route trying to get their fame like all
the way. It
like,
is.
It ain't
it
about
is.
The talent no more, man.
It's not about the talent. People are now in the business of humiliating themselves just for fame.
Oh, man, I'm telling
you. I'm saying, who? Why you want your kid to see you up on the internet screwing another broad?
They ain't thinking about that.
That's crazy. That's crazy. So some of my Google girlfriends out here are commenting about the Kim Kardashian situation. They saying that it's an insurance claim.
Bitch. I can believe it.
That makes sense.
A big time joint.
They saying it's an insurance claim.
The one for all right, Google girlfriends, or for her.
Just period. Her getting robbed is an insurance claim. We don't know if she's about to get canceled and they looking for a new hustle. You know that mother is smart. Oh, yeah. That mother's smart.
That's a managing ass.
Oh, that's Joe Jackson of the industry, man.
She is genius, man.
That mother
is smart. She's been a genius. She the one who dropped the. I think she dropped the Ray J and Kim tag.
She probably did.
Produced it. She probably was a video person.
Well, let me drop this tea. Y'all know Sheree.
Yeah.
Y'all know Sheree. Y'all Google girlfriend with a strong arm.
Yes.
Y'all know Sheree. Yeah, she's been sued. She's been getting sued again from her contractors. Uh-oh. The house that she's been building for 7 years in Atlanta.
Shout out to them. Yes. I mean, Sheree.
Yes. So it's one of her contractors is suing her again, saying that she didn't pay them for unfinished work that they have done on the house.
Wow.
When is the house going to get finished? And bitch, how much house do you need? Now, Sheree. Now, Sheree. Now, you know, these houses are really, really big. Now, first of all, let me ask y'all, do y'all care for a big house, a little house, small house?
Nice.
Me personally, I'm happy, but I don't need a match or nothing like that.
Yeah, like a nice
4,500 square feet.
But yeah, a nice fat medium sized one.
Right.
I even love the house, my childhood house now.
Right. See, in my childhood house, you know what I'm saying? I like my childhood house too, but I hate when I'm in there by myself and bitch hear noises. Yeah. You know the mouses be moving in the walls. You know the mouses be moving in the walls. The
steps squeaking.
Yeah, the steps are squeaky. Yeah.
You are not going
to. The mouse is moving the wall. Bitch, we all got mice. We southeast. That's where we from. The mouse is moving the wall. And then sometimes they move in your trash can. Bitch, you be like, what's that? You mute the TV? Yeah. And then God forbid if your TV ain't, I mean, your remote ain't working, you got to get up and turn it down. You scared to move. And then you sitting in your house and shit by yourself and something go past your
motherfucker.
They fast as shit, man. Yeah, they fast as shit. Bending them is fast. Yes, Master Splinter in them is fast. Some of us got Ben and some of us got Master Splinter. Yes, okay.
That's
the man. I got Master Splinter, but you need to move. You need to move with Master Splinter walking around in your
liver halves or something because you're disgusting.
Yes. Damn. Okay, but good luck to Sheree. Good luck to Sheree. Do y'all even care that Nicki Minaj and Meek Mills is broken up?
No.
Did y'all even have faith in their relationship?
No.
I thought it was just a publicity
stunt.
Just so she couldn't talk to Drake or, you know, because that. I thought them two was going to end up together.
I did, too.
I think Nicki,
I know I would
like him, genuinely like him, but she, her, I think her team telling her he just ain't a good look. Mm-hmm. She need more of a megastar.
Yeah, right. He take too many L's.
Right. He just recently fell down the stairs coming from his mother's house. He put it up on his Instagram.
Oh, yeah.
He knew it was going to get out, so he said, let me make a joke first before everybody else make a joke.
He got fucked up.
Yeah, she ate the shit out of
the. We all fell down the stairs before. I know I did. Man. I fell in the hole in between Granddaddy's house.
You know what?
Playing on the banister. I did.
Which we shouldn't have been doing.
Yes. But anyway, they saying that Nicki Minaj and Meek Mills did not reportedly break up because he was seeing another girl or she was seeing another dude.
Right.
They said they broke up because Nicki feels that he spent too much time with his friends and not her.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Well, what do you expect, Nicki? He's 16.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Fuck. And you're like 34. Yeah. I mean, compared to him, you know what I'm saying?
Especially mentality wise.
Yes. Okay. Well, on to the next one. So, get this. We all know about Soulja Boy and Chris Brown. Are y'all excited about this fight?
No.
I want to see that excited.
I really want to see the other people get it on. I want to see T.I. and Mayweather do
T.I. will get the gun quick. But look, let me tell y'all this. So, you know, apparently they're supposed to be taking the fight. They're supposed to be taking the fight and put it on pay-per-view. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? They're not doing it in Vegas because it's a lot of laws that Vegas, you know, requires. Right. And guess what one of the laws is?
What?
A drug test.
Oh, yeah.
So they said, no, we got to go out of the country. So they're going to Dubai.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's where they're going to do the fight at, in Dubai.
Uh-huh.
And guess who's singing the national
Rihanna.
Anthem? Nope.
Oh.
Kelly Price.
Oh.
Kelly Price. 50 Cent called Kelly Price.
Damn.
That's when
I didn't even know where she was at.
Yes.
All people, her?
Yes, they picked Kelly Price.
That's dope, though. What do you mean her like that?
I mean, I don't see that being her type of an event. Singing that at a Soulja Boy and Chris Brown.
Yes. Her attitude and got her ass.
I would have loved Rihanna to do it. That would have been great.
Said called Kelly Price it. "This is Mr. Big." And she said, "How you doing, Mr. Big?" Then he said, "What the hell is going on? What you mean, what's going on? You ain't dropped an album. Can you sing the national anthem?" "Ooh, yeah, I needed a bitch man in a secret." It's like, no, but that's what she's going to be doing.
Though. I had to hit the bell on that one. You ate
the- So that's what's going on. That's my tea for today. Yeah, so Rob, what do you got for us?
All right, my first story, an argument over grilled cheese sandwich leads to armed standoff with police. It's hilarious.
Damn.
Daniel.
He must was hungry.
Daniel Blackwell, 55, became angry with his wife and took a bite of that. His wife took a bite of a sandwich and shot at her through the basement floor, she said.
Hold on, Ron. Hold on. So he took a bite of her sandwich.
No, she took a bite of his sandwich, Ron.
And went to go get the gun and shoot at him.
No. Bitch. So she made the sandwich for him.
Uh-huh.
Took it downstairs to him.
Uh-huh.
Back upstairs. So he went to bite into the sandwich and noticed the sandwich had got bitten into.
Before he bit it.
Before he bit it.
Yeah.
So he got mad as shit, shot upstairs. Went upstairs to look and see where the bullets went.
Uh-huh.
Went back downstairs and shot in the facility where she was at. He tried to really kill her
over a bite of a grill.
It had to be more, but that was the final straw.
That's a mentally challenged relationship.
That's something you would do. That's what I said. Don't fuck with his food.
Women.
That's why you're single.
No. But women do all the time when you take them out to eat, always fucking with your food and shit.
But you don't get no gun and shoot at a bitch.
You're right though. That was
you don't do that.
And he was gonna stage it too. So when he, because it was gonna be an accident.
So they had 15 guns. They took 15 guns out of his house, which 5 was loaded.
Oh damn!
And charged him with first degree assault.
He had more guns than T.I.
Man, I'm trying to tell you, he was serious with it.
Yeah, so they locked his ass up.
Yeah, they got his ass.
All that over sandwich. That ain't right. Yes. D, what you got for us for the tea?
Say what now?
Say what?
A waitress says white couple left a racist note and no tip on their receipt.
Okay, so the waitress was black. And what happened?
And I looked up this joint online, man. This joint just sad. A waitress in Ashburn, Virginia area says a couple decided not to leave a tip, but instead wrote a racist message on their bill.
What was the message?
It said, "Great service. Don't tip black people." That note was scrawled at the bottom at the bill of Anita's Mexico Style Cafe in Ashburn on Saturday morning.
What would you would have did if somebody would have left that for you?
See, that it's tough, man. That's why I don't really like that type of work force. Because it's like you deal with those type of people.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know what I'm saying? You always got a chance of coming across a customer like that. So it's like my way of handling things is different from everybody else's way.
Right.
So it's like
how you would have handled it? If you went back to the table, you see, they probably would have been gone. They fuck around with a scene. You as their waiter, they would have said, "New waiter."
And I would have probably agreed.
They probably would have like, "New waiter."
But nah, I don't know, man. Now that I'm in my position that I'm in now, you know, I probably would have been like, "Man, let that shit go."
But. Right. But back in the day, you would have chased their ass with your apron on and everything. Sammy, so what is your tea you got for us today?
A little something to make you think.
Okay.
So who's to blame for Tashauna Green stealing a $9,000 Louis Vuitton dress?
She's the blame.
She is the blame because she had no motherfucking business.
Right, and how did she get that dress out the store?
Because she makes a living out of it, apparently.
Okay, so she's a fucking booster.
She's a booster, caducer, truther.
Okay, so what happened? Give us the tea.
Basically, she stole the dress.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of people went off about it or whatever like that. So one commentator on Centric's Facebook page said she should have stole some sense. Okay, it's very clear that if Green had the means to buy nearly a $10,000 designer dress, she would have. Instead, she embarked on a reported criminal career of stealing expensive garments and purses. But why?
Oh, so she make a career out of stealing this stuff.
Yes. So it's not really about what happened to her if she's go to jail. The message is about black materialism that we all as black people suffer from.
Yeah.
It is basically systematic.
Being hip, having the designer bags
and
stuff shoes.
Like that, and you know, not doing the prioritizing and really right. taking care of your priorities.
Right.
And some people are really sick with it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Just to have a image or be portrayed in a certain way. And social media is making it even worse.
Yes. Uh-huh.
And then people don't have any guidance like that. See, I was raised where my mother, my father told me, style is about how you live.
Right. Mm-hmm. Not about what you wear.
Not about what you wear.
Right.
That means live in your house, live in your house.
Right.
Inside of you.
Right.
How you live. Like, because I'm rich as shit when it comes to live, okay?
Right, uh-huh.
I'm a billion gazillionaire, okay?
Yeah, uh-huh.
I'm an heiress.
Right.
Because I was born into with my family, and they let me down.
Right,
you know?
Uh-huh.
And they taught me a lot. But at the end of the day, it's just basically your mentalities have to change.
Right.
Black materialism is basically, a form of greed.
It's a disease.
It's a disease.
And they need
a
cure.
And it's causing us as a whole race to fail, like, really.
Even, and it's not just black women, it's black men, too.
And
like that, too.
And catch this.
I was about to ask y'all, why do y'all think that that's, you know.
It's not just women. It's, you know what?
No, I'm saying, why do y'all think that it's so common amongst.
Because this,
you know what? I'm going to take that back. I don't even think it's a race thing, period. I think it's people in general. Because there's some white people that's like that, too. You know what I'm saying? There's Asian people like that, too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but...
That they feel like they have to have certain things.
I feel like black people break their necks.
Some people do. Mm-hmm. And you're paying it to a white company at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Now, if you think about that, Louis Vuitton won't even put their fucking bags on clearance. They'd rather burn them first.
That's true.
Okay?
Yeah, they ain't marking shit.
So think about that, too.
Right.
Okay? Think about it.
Mm-hmm.
We need to start supporting more black businesses.
And also, think about this, okay? No, for real. Also think about this. Everybody that pretend that they have it, bitch, really don't.
Huh?
Someone is on Instagram taking pictures with their cousin shit on.
All right.
Okay, for real.
And some motherfuckers be looking flash, should be having on $6,000 shoes, $2,000 jeans, honey, and the inside of their house look fucked up.
Yes.
Like a trap house, bitch.
Yes. Some of that stuff, they don't prioritize. You know what I'm saying? People are so quick to be judged by look. Mm. You know what I'm saying? When it's all about the heart and how you treat people.
I'm so glad I got that at an early age. Yes. Thank you, God.
Yes, thank you, Jesus. Ron still thinks it's about the look.
Nah, I don't.
He went in the store with me. He said, I'm a fly motherfucker. If the fuck you think I'm about to sit here and boost your motherfucking ear, you roll on these older redhead fucker. I'm not about to do it. You better get that bitch that don't want you to do it. You better get that bitch that don't want you to do it. I'm not her. Matter of fact, where is she at?
I can't say
we got money to do that.
We have a special guest today. Oh, we have a special guest today, Google Girlfriends. We have a special motherfucking guest, and I am so excited about our special guest because she's all about what I'm about, self-love.
Yeah.
So I'm excited to sit here and talk to her, okay? Her name is Lily Wilson. Come on up!
Yes, Lily Wilson. Well, she came through.
She came through. Look at Lily.
Yes,
Lily is snap.
I have my team.
Yes, ooh. You do. So we have Lily Wilson here, and Lily is an author. She's not just an author. She's a motivator.
Ooh.
She's not just a motivator. She's a beautiful woman.
Yeah.
And she's a preacher's daughter.
Ooh.
Yes. Oh, Lily is a preacher's daughter.
Ooh.
Yes. And she is a preacher's daughter, in case y'all don't know, of a big time preacher here in the metropolitan area.
I was waiting.
Okay. Willie Wilson over there at Union Temple.
Ooh.
Yes.
Ooh.
The gangsta of gospel. Yes. Gangsta of gospel.
Word. That's legend.
Yes.
All right, Lily.
So I got to be careful before I disappear. I gotta be careful what I say to Lily. But no, thank you so much. But before we get into your book, I just want to know your opinion about the church today, especially with all going on with Kim Burrell and all that other stuff. Like, what's your opinion about today's churches?
Today's church has to be relevant.
Uh-huh.
Today's church has to know the population it serves. Tradition and the written word is often made a priority over just dealing with everyday life.
Right.
And one thing that I understand about the word, and one thing that
she don't have to put that on wrong. She okay.
And one thing that I understand about, you know, the Bible is that, you know, it was speaking of specific people at a specific time, and people always like to utilize that to oppress people. Mm-hmm. And it was used to oppress Black people. It was used to justify slavery. So at this particular point, it's used to justify, you know, homophobia and basically saying, you know, you're going to hell and all of that, when really we don't know. Who really knows? Right. Who really knows?
Right.
Who's going?
Right.
You know, where heaven is, where hell is. Who really knows?
Right.
You know, all we have is what we've been passed down. But is God not still speaking today? Huh. Like, you know, does God not still have a voice today for this generation and this population? So the best thing we can do is love. Love.
Oh, I feel the Holy Spirit up in here. Yes, I feel it. I feel it. Oh, come on.
It's just a melt through my body.
Yes, that's right. It's all about love. So what is, was it hard for you growing up in the church?
Actually, not really. Not when it comes to my parents. My parents are very down to earth.
Yes.
You say the
yes. The gangster. The gangster of gospel. Yes.
Yes. The gangster. Yes. Very chill. Uh-huh. I love my parents. Never put undue and just superficial standards on me.
Right.
But where the standards and the, you know, oppression and the expectations came was with other people.
Right.
You know, society. Trying to say who you should be and how you should be because you supposedly belong to a particular group.
Right.
So, you know, I've never felt that pressure from within, more so from without.
Oh,
you're the preacher's daughter. You suppose a whatever or the other. I have a 3-year-old. I'm not married. So, of course, you know, you face
judgment. Do people in the congregation come down on you for that?
A couple of people tried to, but for the most part, I hold my own.
Ooh.
You know, I said, well, yeah,
that's why you're supposed to.
So she's a gangster too, Sammy.
No, that's why.
Yeah.
I'm just all about love. And
yes.
You can't judge me. You, when you live in a glass house,
yes.
You cannot throw stones.
Oh, you and better talk about it. I'm about to run in here.
What I understand is when you lead with love, you can never go wrong. I'm not going to sit up there and apologize for being a beautiful woman and being a sexual and creative being. I'm not going to do that. So, and my baby is a blessing, and she's amazing. So now
I like you. You know, I would never think that me as a yellow, happy, excited gay man would have this good conversation with a preacher's daughter.
Really?
Amen. And I am loving it. Yeah. Yeah, so you're all about love. Yeah. You're all about loving each other.
Yeah, yeah.
So when it comes to homosexuality in the church, how do you feel about that?
Well, I just feel that it's something that we need to be very sensitive with. Mm-hmm. And even if you don't agree, you have to be very careful with how you articulate your disagreements. We all have different ways that we live our lives.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So it's just a matter of love and respect. And
right.
You can't really, you know, I don't even look at this as a sin and that as a sin. It's not really about that for me. It's about, you know, what resonates with you in your spirit.
Right.
And who ultimately is the ultimate judge for you.
Right.
I cannot impose my judgments upon you.
Right.
I just cannot.
No one can.
Yeah. Right. And
no one can, Lily.
Yeah.
Yeah. No one can, Lily.
Yeah. And everybody needs to rightly divide the word, as they say, and stop trying to use certain scriptures to hate particular people.
Right.
And everybody is doing things that are wrong or
right.
Or things that they could learn to grow from.
Even people on the pulpit, right?
Even people on the pulpit.
Yes, Lily, the preacher's daughter said it. Yes.
Well, that's, Lord. Well, one thing I do know, well, being a preacher's kid and being a part of the gospel industry at a point, you are privy to a lot of things that go on behind the scenes.
Yes.
And there's
yes.
a lot that goes on behind the scenes. So you couldn't possibly stand there and come for the homosexuals and the bisexuals, the LGBT community
right.
when you are living foul.
Right.
And, you know, when you are not living what you preach. It's,
right.
It's very hypocritical. And I'm so anti.
Right.
Oh,
you just have to love.
That's you are glowing. And let me tell y'all something. Let me tell y'all something, Google Girlfriends, okay? On YouTube land and on Facebook. First of all, they're loving you on here. They're saying, that's right. Aww. She's beautiful. I love her. She's well-spoken. That's right, Google Girlfriends. Yes. All right? So, but let me tell you something, okay? Yes. First of all, when she came in here, Google Girlfriends, she flipped the script of the scent in here, okay? Now, normally when I come in here, it smells like old cheese. But when Lily came in here, it smells beautiful. Now, sometimes it's loud. Sometimes it's loud. And sometimes it's oh geez, Lily. Okay? Lily right here, oh geez. Okay. But today you done bought a beautiful set. Yes. Yeah. I asked her earlier what she was wearing when she first came in here. She said she got it from what, Urban Outfitters?
Right, yes.
I need to go pick that up.
Yes,
it smells really good.
You will wear that?
Yes, I would wear that. Oh, and you listen to what the fuck she said? No judge. No judge. Yes. Do you wear hair grease? Do you wear hair grease? No judging. Okay? Okay. So, Lily, let me ask you this. How did Kim Burrell's statement affect you? Like, what was going through your mind when you heard that?
I just really think that we ought to be very, very careful.
Right.
Just period. And, you know, I understand that sometimes when we're in the preacher moment, we get kind of hype, and you know, a lot of people are saying, you know, she was just preaching the truth, but there was a lot of opinion in there as well.
Right.
And it was also a lot of judgment in there too.
Right.
So you just have to be very careful with that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that at this point she, you know, I'm not celebrating that she's, you know, lost all she's lost.
Right, me neither.
You know, but at the same time, it's just like, you have to be very careful. Lead right. with love. And I'm not perfect either, but as a constant reminder, like, you know, I have a bag that has love on it, you
right.
know, big bold letters, to lead with love, even when you don't understand.
Right.
You have to be very careful. And then the name she was calling out,
uh-huh.
I was just like, be very, very careful.
Yeah, she was talking about putting penises in the face, yes. shaking titties in the
yes.
face.
And I'm super sensitive because I've always been a friend to the LGBT
right.
community. And, you know, a lot of my friends, you know, I support them, you know, I have no issue. So it's just, I was just like, ooh.
Right.
It hurt my feelings a
yes,
little bit.
Yes, it did. But you know, I hate to see her lose what she lost. Yeah, how do you feel about that?
Well, we just all have to be prayerful and extend love to each other.
Right.
Because she's entitled to her beliefs and how she applies those beliefs.
Right.
Whether you agree or not. You know, I don't yeah. necessarily believe that anybody else is going to hell faster than I am.
Right.
You know,
uh-huh.
Or where is this hell that we speak of? I'm not even sure about that either. But
right.
I just know that, you know, you got to be really careful, and everybody's entitled to what they believe. But just show love.
Right.
Just show love.
That's all.
Now, for those of you that don't know, she's not just an author, a preacher daughter, but she can sing.
Oh, my
I knew
God.
It.
Yes, she can sing.
I didn't know.
Lily. Yes. Lily can sing. Sing, you know, she was in the world famous Eastern Senior High School choir.
Oh, well, you're a Rambler. Okay.
Yes. She led a couple of solos. Yes.
Yes.
She was also in, of course, she was in the choir at her father's church.
Yes.
She also got a song on there at the children's CD.
Youth choir, yes.
Yes, the youth choir.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. See, I do my research.
Yes.
That's my girl. Yes. I do my research. Yes, she is a songbird. Yeah. She can really sing.
Wow.
Now, out of all of the things that you do, what do you find the most joyful out of the things that you do? Because we all got our favorite thing that we do.
Yes.
Being on stage is a huge one. You know, music is so spiritual. And music is just like, it moves you in places that nothing else can. You know, to make you move some hips.
You know, I know about the hip movement.
It'll convince your heart. It'll, you know, you can identify with it. If it's about a heartbreak, everybody's been there. If it's about love, everybody can go there. It paints a picture. Like, country music is one of my favorites.
Oh, really?
It can really paint a picture. The lyrics, oh my goodness.
Yeah.
It can really paint a picture.
Have you ever did a country song before?
I have not.
Oh,
I have not.
I seen you on your Instagram and you was listening to this song and you questioned the lyrics.
Oh, yes. Oh, my gosh. I can't even think of the artist, but it's an old song. Uh-huh.
I like that song.
Yeah,
I was feeling it, Lily.
I love it. Yeah, he said something about... something about your heart.
Heart and your mind.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
The way he phrased it. I love lyrics.
Uh-huh.
Music is huge.
Yes. Me. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, like I said, Lily is an author, and this is her book. Yes, it's called The Love Diet.
Yes.
And this is my copy, T-Body, because I think Lily knows besides me and Sammy, we're the only two here that reads. Okay, so.
Yes.
So,
did I get a copy?
This is her book, and her book is all about self-love.
Yes.
Now, you have certain days that you should be doing certain things within this book.
Yes.
And that is amazing. So, let me ask you this. What inspired you to write this book?
What initially inspired me is that, you know, I definitely a very spiritual person. So when I sit still, you know, the question came to me, what would happen if you poured the love in for 365 days? Mm-hmm. So I'm like, okay, a whole year, I don't think anybody's going to do that process. So I kind of like diminished the process for to make it like palatable.
Right.
And I said, okay, let's do 22 days, mm-hmm. 365 hours. It's 15 days. We'll do 7 days pre-work. And that's how you have the love diet. It's 22 mm-hmm. days of intentional self-love. And I think anybody should be able to do 22 days without getting ADHD and right. without getting distracted, yeah. you know?
Right.
So, and so that's why I produced the process in the book, and I've had several sessions. We do like group sessions where we have mm-hmm. like, you know, a support system and how's your, you know, 22 days coming and so right. forth. So it's just a way to kind of diminish the year-long process. But I'm going to do the year-long process with the group soon, but we just haven't gotten there yet.
So a lot of my Google girlfriends got questions for you, so I'm yes. going to read them, y'all. I see y'all.
Yeah.
Lakeisha Clay wants to know, where can she get your book from?
Okay, you can go on createspace.com, or you can get it from amazon.com and just search Lily Wilson, L-I-L-I, The Love Diet, and it should come up.
Okay, say it one more time and speak okay. a little louder, because she's giving y'all that sexy panty voice.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry about that. amazon.com, just search Lily Wilson, L-I-L-I Wilson, or you can go on Create Space, either one. You okay. should have it in a couple days. If you got that Amazon Prime, it will be at your door. Trust me.
Oh, okay. Right. Yes. So that's where y'all can get the book from, Amazon. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yes. So how do you deal with, like, what do you think the first step is to loving yourself?
Okay. The first.
Because a lot of people struggle with loving themselves.
Okay. Right. The first step is to silence the noise. Any way that you've been raised and conditioned to believe, such as like a religious atmosphere or just in your familiar atmosphere and your community, there's not a lot of teachings on self-love. So you kind of have to like separate yourself from what you've always been taught, from who people have said you are, from what people have said about you, and get still. And you have to really mm-hmm. go inward, and whatever your way of going inward, some people go inward through listening to gospel music. Some people mm-hmm. go inward with meditation, yoga. Get centered, because from your center, that's where your spirit will speak to you. I call it a divine compass.
Yes.
And that's where you get your instructions, and that's where you get, you know, your true religion, for real.
Yes.
You know, that's yes. where it comes from. It comes from within you. You know, the breath of God is inside of you. So whatever resonates with you and your spirit, that's what should lead and guide you. So that is first. You have to get still and centered so you can have a good sense of who you are without all of the what your parents said about you and who right, said you weren't going right, to be this right, and right, all of that. Right. Silence the noise and get to know you and your God voice.
You're good.
Yeah!
She's good.
That's yes! In stuff. One way, wrong, because the whole time you just staring at her in a fucking day. In one way, it's
no, because I'm going to tell you why. Like, she's good. Like, that's her words are like really inspirational. Like
right.
I'm sitting back really listening to it. Like, and I like having.
Are you listening or dazing and imagining?
Oh. No, I am listening. Uh-huh. And I had a question. So do you think self-love is the main ingredient that's missing as far as relationships? Because a lot of relationships are like that I hear about or that I read about through social media, it's like on the decline and also marriages. So I always was a firm believer. Like, if you don't love yourself, how could you love anybody else?
I think that's very important, and I very think that's true. A great point. You have to learn to love yourself. But one thing we've been taught is that it's better to give to receive, and we've been taught to love your neighbor as yourself. But see, the thing is, you've not been taught what loving yourself looks like. So how can you duplicate that anywhere else? And not only are you like seeking love somewhere else, you don't even know what it looks like because you right. don't know what you like yourself. So as you get to know yourself and you know, center yourself and understand that God voice, you'll start figuring out what makes you tick, what you like, what you don't like, you know. Mm. And because a lot of times we get our identity from our environment.
Right.
You know, everybody yes. tells us how to dress and what to do and how to be and how to show up. We get it from our religion. But when you get centered and you learn, this is what I like. Oh, this is what I like. And
right.
it don't matter if nobody else likes it, but yes. this is what I enjoy. So that's a huge part. And then you can start to invite people into that. And then you understand that it's nobody else's job to make you happy. You make yourself happy.
Yes, Lily.
And from there, you have something to give to others.
Talk your shit on the morning tea with Lonnie Bee. Yes. Oh, we got mail. All
right.
Yes, we got mail. We're going to get right back to Lily. They are going crazy.
My God.
Are a great guest. She's all about what I'm about, self-love. Okay. This is a good question since we got Lily here. Okay, and I'm going to give this to Lily today. We're going to give our mail to Lily. The question is from the community. This is our community mail. It says, should couples live together before marriage?
Lord have mercy. You ask me that. Lord have mercy. I would say to each his or her own. His or his and hers and hers own. I'm just saying, whatever you feel is, you know, essential to the growth of your relationship. Everybody's timeline is different.
Right.
Don't let anybody tell you this is what should come first come love, then come marriage, then come no.
Right.
For me, it might be different than
right.
you.
Right.
So don't live your life according to anybody else's standards but your own. And again, you know, we could talk about what the Bible says and what you're supposed to do and what's right and what's not right. But you have the Spirit of God in you that governs you and can tell you what is right for you.
Right. Speak your shit. Speak your shit. Spend the night. Spend the night. Lily, spend the night. So a lot of my Google girlfriends are asking, are you having a book signing?
I'm having an event in March. It's actually our spring session of the Love Diet. And you can find more information if you can, if you go on my website, lilywilson.com, and you can sign up there to be a part of my email distribution list, or you can go to lovedietonline.com, and that has the dates, and it'll be open soon for registration, and you can register. And then at the end of it, I am going to have a session in person. Like, all of the sessions are over the phone, it's conference calls, but at the end I'm gonna have a live session so I can sign your book then.
Yes. Oh my God. So what would you say to that woman that feels she can't love herself if this man isn't loving her? Because a lot of women feel incomplete if a certain guy is not loving them the way they want that guy to love them.
The way that they want that guy
to love them.
That's loaded. That's very loaded because, first of all, we all have expectations.
Uh-huh.
We all have to understand that a person can only love them based on their capacity. So you cannot expect somebody to love you the way you love somebody else.
Right.
You cannot expect somebody to be anybody except who they are. 9 times out of 10, people are who they are. They might shift a little bit. They may mature a little bit. But if I'm very affectionate, I cannot expect you to be as affectionate as I am. You are who you are.
Right.
So you have to expect them to be the best version of themselves and not be the best version of you duplicated, you know, in a partner.
So that goes back to that Maya Angelou statement.
Yeah.
When people show you who they are,
believe them. Yes, and stop trying to expect something that they don't have the capacity to give.
Can I chime in on that?
Please go.
Go ahead.
So, keeping it 100, a lot of those issues with women come from a lot of women not having no fathers in their life. Like, because that's your first love, and that should be your role model of love, you know, because that's the person that's going to teach you how you should be loved, how you're supposed to be treated, and how a man is supposed to treat a woman. If you're not learning that from your father, you could be learning from a clown-ass nigga. You could be learning from a guy with a lot of money who just playing, just throwing money at you. So she don't know. So it's not the woman's fault. It's just, I hate to blame it on a father or a man, but I mean, it is, though, because that's they first.
What you think about that, Lily?
That's true to a degree. I think it does start in the home, but I also think it starts with education. You know, it's not just with somebody being there. It's about you empowering your children, you empowering yourself. You are your best advocate. You know, we talk about in the Love Diet, being your authentic self. Don't try to be anybody else than who you are to please anybody. Be who you are. You're amazing as you are. And the more we do, you know, affirm, it's, you know, I'm not saying that they won't miss a father or they won't miss a mother that's absent. But the more you affirm them as a loving being and as a creative being who is capable of doing anything they put their minds to, they'll be able to get that confidence and go from there. Mm-hmm. I mean, I do believe there's some validity in, you know, having a missing parent, but I also think that that education piece has to go there. Again, we just assume that you're going to learn to love yourself as you love the neighbor. That's not a good assumption. You have to teach self-love from an early age. Yep. Love right. yourself. Mm. You are beautiful. You are amazing. Affirm yourself. Look in the mirror. Tell yourself. You got to instill that from an early age.
But, you know, in this generation, in this day and time, a lot of people lack love from home.
Yeah. Definitely.
So how do they seek it and find it if they not getting it from home?
I think that's where, you know, the mentors come in and where the churches are supposed to come in.
Right.
And instead of the browbeating and saying how wrong you are and how filthy you are, you know, the church can be abusive.
Right.
You know, calling you filthy rags.
And, right.
You know, asking you to look outside of yourself to this amazing God, but you're dirty and filthy. No, that same God that created you is in you. You are it.
Right.
You are God.
Yes.
You have God living and breathing inside of you, and you're amazing. And right. you can surpass any obstacle. So you have to teach that. You know, our institutions have to step in and start teaching that self-esteem and self-empowerment and self-love.
Right.
Yeah.
So how do people get in touch with their inner God?
Again, well, for me, yoga, meditation, worship. Mm-hmm. I love worship music. That's for each person, it's different.
Right.
It just depends on what really touches you. Oh, nature is a huge one. Yeah. Oh, my
right.
gosh. Some people feel God at the ocean.
Yeah.
You know?
That's me. It's so,
sitting yeah. in the park.
Yeah. yeah
oh, my God.
Bro, don't yeah. stop. You no. said you're not a religious dude.
No, I'm talking
don't
about
try to impress her.
Man, look
don't
out
try
the
to
world.
Impress her. Don't try to impress her.
I know he's trying real hard.
Yeah.
You know how sometimes when you're gazing at the water and it's like some weird little thing just like, mm-hmm. I feel it through my body. Yeah. Like it's like I feel like I'm being hypnotized, but yeah. I'm not.
Right.
That's mm-hmm. exactly what it is. It's, you know, some people in the woods, some people hiking is the way they connect.
Right.
To, you know, the divine. It's just whatever, wherever you feel peace and you feel that stillness, you like, oh, there it is. That's where God is for you. That's mm-hmm. where God is for you.
For me, mine's is weird.
What is
when
it?
When I get, what wrong?
Of course.
No. Go ahead. Mine is weird, but I get in touch with God when I'm cleaning the house.
Mm-hmm.
Like yeah. when I'm sweeping and mm-hmm. I'm cleaning, you know, mm-hmm. I really get in touch with him. Mm-hmm. Or when I'm riding it, but I have to turn the music down.
Yeah.
Like them long rides,
mm-hmm.
you know,
yeah.
when I don't have to pick anybody up.
Yeah. Yeah, for some people it is driving, going on a road trip. They just drive to clear their yeah. mind and to get that stillness. Yeah.
Right.
Wherever you feel that, wherever you get your peace from, it's like, okay, there it is.
Right.
Mine is a corner of a boat and just looking out at the water.
Mm-hmm.
And I got me a nice little drink or something.
Right.
Man, shit, that's the best right there.
Right. No, you were drunk right there.
No, that was a buzz.
That was a buzz. I'm about to say the same thing. I'm about to say hitting the gym. Well,
so look,
I do that. Yeah.
So look, Lily, I know like we all go through our trials and tribulations of life.
Yeah.
But when you face those things, how do you get back in touch with yourself?
Oh my goodness. I am very much an advocate of intentional breathing.
Mm-hmm.
You could be having a moment, and I call it you can reset at any moment. I don't care if you think you're having the worst day, you mm-hmm. can reset. Whatever you need to do to reset, you can take, you know, they teach you this when you have anger issues.
Right.
Take deep breaths.
Right.
You know, uh-huh. in and out. Again, you know, with God being inside of you, breath is the way that you connect with the God in you.
Mm-hmm.
So you start taking those deep breaths. And if you notice when you're just living life on a regular, you're not taking deep breaths. You're just like, just breathing.
Right.
But when you take a moment and take those deep intentional breaths, you can reset that whole moment.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing is gratitude. Gratitude mm-hmm. will shift a moment. And when you start counting the things that you're grateful for, it'll outweigh the things that are going wrong. When you start looking at those things around you, okay, at least I got a shirt on. Like, at least yeah. I have clothes. At least I have food. Okay, at least I have something to drink. Like, you know, and it will outweigh some of the issues. It doesn't mean they disappear, but it will give you a new mindset and a reset, so you can deal with it.
Also, that brings the energy to attract more good things too, yes, because you get a thing.
Exactly.
Right. I know, because I'm going through that right now.
Yeah,
right.
Totally.
No, seriously.
Yeah. She got everybody talking so bello.
Yeah.
Y'all know that?
The whole bello. You know, yeah. The energy.
I feel at peace. Oh, you feel at peace? Yeah. Am I the only loud gay one?
Yeah.
So, D said, deeply.
Shut up. Shut up, D.
So look, so in your book, you talk about dating yourself.
Yes.
And getting intimate with yourself. Uh-huh. Now, this line, I want you to explain to me. You says, this is where you court yourself, date yourself.
Okay.
What do you mean when you say court yourself?
Well, a lot of us are looking for somebody else to wine and dine us. Many of
You better talk about it. I'm leaving. I'm getting out of here.
Come on now, Lily.
I'm leaving. So, go ahead, Lily. Come
for
on now,
somebody
Lily.
Somebody to impress us and woo us. Uh-huh. But what have you done for yourself?
Yeah.
Okay. How have you impressed yourself?
Right.
So, and that goes for that is. You know, that inner validation that we're talking about, having your core on point. Like, you're waiting for somebody to buy you flowers. Buy yourself some flowers.
Yep. Hello.
Love on yourself. I make sure I keep fresh flowers in my home just because I love it. I make sure I keep candles around because I love it.
Yeah.
And it's something that I love. And the thing is, when you do it for yourself, people that come along, they will join in on the party. Mm-hmm. Like, it's already a party going on. It's a self-love. It's a me party going on. So just join in. I'm not looking for you to change. Or, you know, if you add in some more, I love it. And yes. I welcome it. And it's wonderful. But I can do it for myself as well. And that doesn't mean I don't need you. But I can do it as well. And I appreciate myself. And I show myself that appreciation.
Come on, preacher Lily. Daughter is independent. Did you get that?
Did you get it?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So listen, on one of your chapters, we're actually day 7.
Okay.
Okay? You talk about mirrors.
Okay.
Okay, and you say, that's blame is usually a mirror reflecting those same things I judge back at me.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Oh, when you're a spade, you can call a spade a spade.
Right. Uh-huh.
You know the fruit because you know the tree, because you exhibit those same qualities. Things that I see in you is what I see in myself. So everybody that you interact with is a mirror. Relationships are mirrors. They show you yourself in this most uncomfortable way because it's meant to grow you and it's meant to shift you. So mirrors are, you know, the relationships in our lives. And basically, a lot of us run away from the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing that you have to understand is that if you can see the drama, that means you got some drama in you too.
Oh.
You know, if you can call out the hatred, that means you have some hatred in you too. You know, it's basically you see.
Because you identify what you experience.
Yes. And many times we don't want to deal with that in ourselves, but it's easy to call that out in others. So that's why you have to be really, really intentional about those moments when you're shown that mirror. It's like, okay, wait a minute. So how have I exemplified these qualities? Like, ooh, she's so dramatic. I'm the main one always calling somebody dramatic, but I know that I'm dramatic.
Yes, that's why you can identify.
I can
identify
it.
Yes,
so if you're in a relationship and your partner always accuses you of cheating, that's because they cheat, so they figure, I know you're cheating because I know what I do.
That, and it could be, and it could be fear as well. So the reason why I see that in you is basically my fears projecting onto you.
Oh,
you know, I'm fearful, so I'm projecting. I'm gonna call you a cheater, but instead of calling out my fears, I'm just gonna point at the fact that I think you're cheating because I'm really fearful. What I want to say is I'm afraid to be vulnerable. What I want to say is I'm afraid to give my heart to you, but instead, I have the defense up and I'm going to call you a cheater because I have insecurities.
Who needs Dr. fucking Phil when you got Lily? Lily, I'm glad I got your number, girl.
I need your number. I need to come to some goddamn session.
Who needs Dr. Phil when you got Lily?
In a motherfucking building.
Oh, yes.
God,
so, Lily, let's talk here, okay? Oh, now, on day 15, you talk about balance.
Yes.
And I like this, okay? Mm-hmm. It says, I am finding a way to balance self-love and loving others.
Yes.
How do you do that?
Well, let me just say this. Growing up as a preacher's kid, you learn people-pleasing very early.
Mm. Uh-huh.
You learn how to be inauthentic because people want you to be on all the time. And I'm a dreamer, so I'm just like in my own world. And it's not that I don't want to speak. I'm just dreaming.
Right.
So mm-hmm. you just learn, oh, she can't speak. Then you learn how to, you know, fake speak. Well, not me so much, but a lot right. of preacher's kids, because generally I'm authentic and I have been, but you just kind of learn people pleasing. But where the balance comes in is, you know, sometimes you have to be selfish, excuse me, and pull back and love on yourself some more. But then you have to learn that balance, right, of give and take. You have to learn to be present with others as you're present with yourself. There's nothing like this energy, like being around people of like mind and like spirit, right. and just having that energy. Nobody is an island. So you have to figure out that balance of, I don't need nobody. Yes, you do. Everybody needs someone. And then, you know, that independence is wonderful, but at the same time, you don't want to be so needy that you're not being authentic and just putting yourself out there just so you can have friends. So you just balance it out. You have to learn to balance it out.
Yes. Yeah. And this one, I love this one, Lily. See, I got the book.
Yes.
I got the book, Lily.
Yes.
I want that book.
So I like this one, day 19.
Yeah.
It's about speaking up.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. And you says, I accept the challenge to speak up when necessary.
Yes.
With love. But like, I mean what I say.
Yes.
I no longer suffer in silence.
Yes.
Oh, I like that. Yes. I love that. I no longer suffer in silence.
Yes.
Talk about it, Lily.
Well, let me just say that many times we'll assume that the people around us know what we want and know what we need.
Right.
So it's very important to speak up when necessary. And a lot of times we lead with blame first, but instead of blame, lead with your vulnerability. I feel like not you did this, you did. No, lead with love and understanding and vulnerability. Say how you feel. Mm-hmm. So it's important to learn when to speak up, because sometimes people always speaking up. They always got something to say, always offended, always on the defensive.
Right.
But there's a difference when you learn how to speak up. And let me just backtrack. Some people think that humility is being like, no, it's okay, and just cowering down and allowing people to get away with things because you're being a good Christian,
right?
You know, or you're being a good person, but you're silencing yourself. You're filtering yourself instead of speaking up. There's a difference between being assertive and being aggressive. Mm-hmm. And when you're assertive, you can assert yourself and speak up in love, as opposed to being super aggressive and taking everything to heart and being defensive about everything, or being the person that's not speaking up at all and always apologizing for your existence. Suffering in silence is when you just don't feel the confidence to speak up, or because of some type of conditioning, you've been taught not to speak up because it's better to give than to receive.
Right,
treat your neighbor a certain way so you don't get a voice. No, you have a voice. Your voice matters. I don't care if you're Christian, but I don't care what religious group you ascribe to, what you've been taught. You know, it's better to, you know, how they shush the kids up, you know, mm-hmm. and you feel like you don't have a voice. No, you have to find your voice. Don't suffer in silence. Don't suffer in silence. Speak your mind and speak it in love.
Mm. Ladies and gentlemen, Lily. I don't think you heard me. Ladies and gentlemen, Lily. Yeah.
Good fucking morning.
Who the fuck need Dr. Phil when you got Lily? Yes. Oh my God, Lily, thank you so much.
Gosh,
you will be back.
Oh, you will be back.
Thank you. Okay.
And some of those sessions.
You will be back.
And I want that book.
So y'all need to get on Amazon right now.
Right now.
Get this book, Thank The Love Diet, by Lily Wilson, the preacher's daughter.
If you really want to love yourself.
If you want to support my good girlfriend, Lily, because she's my good girlfriend, okay? And it's like a black-owned business. Yes. Make sure, look, they going off on here. Yes. They need the book. They need the book. That's right. It's crack. You need it.
You need
okay?
it.
Okay? The Love Diet. Y'all make sure y'all get Lily Wilson book. Make sure y'all get it. It's on Amazon. And what else?
createspace.com.
Yes. Now, one time for my Google girlfriend and those that might be inquiring, give us your social media information.
It's I am Lily Wilson. That's IAMLILIWILSON. I hope you hit me up.
Yes. So that's I am Lily Wilson. I am Lily Wilson on Instagram,
Twitter.
Facebook.
Yes.
Okay. It's the same, okay? It's the same. It's the same. Yeah. So you don't got to worry. It's hooked on phonics. It's the same, okay? So y'all make sure y'all get this book, The Love Diet. I had a pleasure. It was a pleasure being here. So you done touched my gay little spirit. Oh. Yes, you done touched it. Yes, you touched it. You know, and it's all about self-love, something that
all I about preach self-love.
All around all the United States. So I am so glad to have you here. And I hope you have reached some of my Google girlfriend.
Yes,
she's such a beautiful person. And she smells good. Okay,
she got a bomb vibe.
Yes, honey. Don't you worry. Ron won't be messing with her. She'll be going home after this.
Somebody said, yes. "Save her." Yes.
But make sure you get the book, The Love Diet by Lily Wilson. Thank you so much for coming to the tea party. Yes. We enjoyed you, Lily. You were amazing. And thank you guys so much for joining us here on the Morning Tea with Lonnie Bee. See y'all Thursday at the tea party at 11 a.m. Bye-bye.